Hello everyone, I am Nehal from WS Cube Tech, and in this video we are going to talk about random forest algorithm. So let's get started. So let's just first understand what is random forest algorithm. So random forest is a machine learning algorithm which is based on supervised learning. So what is supervised learning? So it's the supervisor who gonna explain what the input is gonna be and what would be its corresponding output in a training data set. And random forest can be used for both regression as well as classification problems. So regression means where the target variables would be continuous in nature, and classification means where the target variables would be categorical in nature, that is, that are divided into categories. Say for example, categories can be yes or no, right or wrong. Alright, so this random forest can be used for both this regression as well as classification problems. Now, the random forest, as the name suggests, so it is a collection of multiple random decision trees. Now, what is a decision tree? So, we have already covered this thing in our previous tutorial, but in short, a decision tree is a tree structured classifier, and we have already understood this thing that why I'm calling it a classifier. Because when we just feed our training data set into an algorithm, okay, so we get a model, okay, we get a logic or a program, and with respect to this decision algorithm over here, we call this model as a classifier, and that's the result why I'm calling it a classifier. So, a decision tree is nothing but it is a tree structured classifier where we provide this entire training data set over this root node. So this is going to be your root node, or you can also call this as the test node. And based upon the features, okay, so based upon these features, it will just split the data set until it gets to a conclusion that to which particular class the test data belongs to. That is, this leaf node will give you the output, that is the class or the values over here. So this multiple decision trees come together to form a forest, and this forest is called as this random forest. Clear? Now let me just give you the real life example of this random forest. So see, suppose that you want to buy a house over here, that is your dream house over here. Now, in order to just buy this house, or in order to just build a house like this, so what you do, you go to multiple peoples, okay, you discuss about this thing, you discuss about the land prices, you discuss about the property dealers and all in your locality. So you go to each and every people over here in your contact, okay, and you make a decision, and then you come up with a conclusion. That is what the conclusion is, you come up with a result. That is, the result is you will get a house, or you are going to build a house over here. So what is happening in this random forest over here, irrespective of depending upon a single person for a decision, okay, we are going and consulting different peoples over here. So as you can see, I have written here multiple decision trees. So these are your multiple decision trees. So what will happen over here, by consulting this many peoples over here, the strength of our goal will increase, the accuracy will increase, because we will get to a good conclusion, okay. So this is the real life example of this random forest algorithm over here. Now let's just understand that how this algorithm actually works over here. So see, we are having this training data set and test data set, okay, this is our original training data set included with this test data set. So this training data set will comprise of multiple samples and features. Now what are samples? So samples means rows and features means columns. Now in the next step, what we do, from this training data, we will randomly choose the sample of rows and sample of features, and will create a new data set by the name, say, training sample 1. Alright. Again, I will just randomly choose the samples of rows and sample of features, and will create a new data set by the name, say, training sample 2. Okay, so likewise, I can create n number of new data set by choosing the samples and features from this training data set randomly with replacement. Now, what does this replacement means? Now, with replacement simply means that the samples or records can be repeated in all this newly created data set. That is, a particular record can be present in sample 1 as well as in sample 2. And it might not be present in training sample 3. And it might even happen that a particular sample can only be present in a particular sample, that is training sample 1. And this newly created data sets are called as bootstrap samples. Alright. Now, what is the reason why we are creating these bootstrap samples? So the reason why we are creating this bootstrap sample is so that we can construct a decision tree of each of these samples. Now, once we construct this decision trees for all of these each training sample one over here. Now each of this decision tree will give you a predicted result. Say this first one is of class 1, then this is of class 2, then say this is of class 2. So these are nothing but this gonna be your class of value that you're going to get through this decision tree over here. Now next, what we are going to do, we are going to carry out the voting system. So we will perform a vote for each predicted result, and the predicted result with the most votes gonna be your final predictions. So over here it will just say that it belongs to the class 1, and this what the final result says, this is your ensemble classifier. Okay, so this is called as ensemble classifier over here. So see, we have already understood the decision tree algorithm in our previous tutorial. So the output that we get from a single decision tree is a classifier, and I already told you what is meant by classifier. So what we do, we combine all these classifier and generate this ensemble classifier over here. So this ensemble classifier strength is more when compared to all these classifiers over here. Now why? Simply because the number of decision trees are coming together here and it is making a forest over here, thus giving rise to high accuracy and low error rate over here. Now for practical, in this classification algorithm we would be using this iris data set. So this iris is a name of a flower and it is found in three species. So the three species are this iris versicolor, then we have iris setosa, and we have this iris virginica. And in our data set you can see we are having this sepal length, width and petal length and width. So by using this independent variables, we are going to build up a model to predict the species of this iris flower. So we'll straight jump over to our Jupyter notebook and we'll do the practical implementation. So here we are at our Jupyter notebook, and what I will do over here is that first I will just start by importing the data set. So the data set that I'm using is iris, and I'm going to load it from the sklearn. So what I will simply do is I will just write from sklearn import data set, and then with the help of this data set, I'm just going to load this iris. Okay, I will store this inside a variable name, call it as iris. Fine. Now next step, what we are going to do is we will just get this target name and the features name. What I will do is inside my print statement, I will just type iris dot target names, and I will even print up this iris dot, and we have this feature name. Okay, so these are our target names. Okay, so setosa, versicolor, virginica, and what are our features over here? So it is sepal length, sepal width, petal length and petal width over here. Now what we are going to do is we are going to create a data frame, okay, of this iris data set. So what I'm just going to do is with the help of pandas I will just be able to achieve my this goal. So I will just say import pandas, we'll give it as iris name as pd. And over here what I will do is I will just say pd dot and data frame, and inside this what I will simply do over here is that I will just say this sepal length. So I will just copy paste this thing, so sepal length, and what I will simply do is iris and dot, we have this data over here, and inside this I want all the rows and zero column over here. Okay, likewise I will do for all. So I will just say species, and this is gonna be my target. So I'm just gonna say the target over here. Okay, and here we go. So you can see that I have created a data frame over here. Okay, so you can just see that it comprises of this 150 rows and this 5 columns over here. Okay, and what I will simply do is I will just store this inside a variable name and call it as data over here. Fine. And if I just come up over here and if I just show you my head over here, so over here it has given you first 5 records over here. That's it. Now what we are going to do simply over here is that we are going to separate out our independent variable and dependent variable. So this is a dependent variable, right? This species is a dependent variable over what? These are the independent variables, this 4. So what I am simply going to do over here is that x, okay, x is equal to, and I will just pass this data, and it would be in the 2 dimension over here, and I need to pass up this also. What I will do, I will simply copy paste this thing, okay, and we'll do a necessary changes. Okay, so these are your features over here, and inside your y I will just pass up this species over here. So what I will simply do is y is equal to and call it at data, and inside this I will pass this species. So these are your features over here, right? And these are your labels. That's it. Okay, and if I just show you guys my X, okay, so we got this sepal length, sepal width, petal length, petal width. And if I just show you my Y over here, so see, I got this, the species over here. All right. Now what the next step over here is that I need to split my data set over here. So in order to split that data set, I need to import this train underscore test underscore split. So how I'm just going to import this from sklearn. So I'm just going to say from sklearn dot model selection import train underscore test underscore split. And inside this train underscore test underscore split, I will just pass up this X and my Y, and the next I need to pass here the test size. So let's make it as 30%, okay, 3. So I'm just writing 0.3, that is we are just using the ratio as 70-30. So 70%, I will just write it down over here. So 70% would be for training and the remaining 30% would be for testing. Okay, fine. And I will just come up over here, and if I do shift tab over here, so the things that I'm just going to get from this running this line over here is that this X train, X test, Y train and Y test. So I'm simply going to copy paste this thing and I will just store this inside this variable. That's it. Now if I just come up over here, so if I just show you the length of my X train, so see it is 105, okay, and the length of our X test over here, see, you can see 45, okay. So we are splitting in this ratio, 70-30 ratio. All right, so once we have done with this splitting up of our data set over here, okay, so this particular thing, this would act as a new records for our module to test because our module had not seen this data set over here. All right, fine. Now what we need to do is we need to import this random forest module. Now how you do that thing, so what you are going to do is you are going to write from sklearn dot ensemble import R capital random forest classifier. All right, so you are going to import this random forest module over here. And what we are going to do is we are going to create the object of this random forest classifier. So random forest classifier, and inside this if I do a shift tab over here, so you are seeing that I'm getting this n estimator. So this n estimator is what? So it is an argument which simply says that how many trees you want inside your forest over here. So I'm just going to make it default, okay. So I will just copy paste this thing. And along with this, you even saw that we are having this criteria. So by default, this is Gini, okay, which is considered as most accurate as compared to entropy, but you can make it to entropy as well. So as for now, I will just write this down, okay, so that you get an idea. Okay, so I have written this n estimator, default value is 100 over here, and I just told you guys that this simply says that how many decision trees you want inside your forest. And this is the criteria, okay. And this criteria, why it is used? This criteria is used in order to, with respect to this Gini, it calculates a Gini impurity. And if you just make this entropy, so it is used for the information gain over here. And this n estimator, as I said that, so it is just a parameter which is a tree specific, okay. This is just used for the tree specific over here. And moreover to here, I can even specify this random state over here. So I will just make it to 0 over here so that we get the same result over here. Alright, and what I will simply do is I will just make an object over here. So let's call this as a classifier over here, CLF. Okay, fine. Now next what we need to do is once we have created this object of this random forest classifier, now we need to just train our this model over here. So in order to train our model, we make use of this fit method. So I'm just going to do CLF dot fit, and inside this I will just pass this X train and this Y train, okay. So once done with this, so this line simply says that now our module is completely ready in order to do the predictions over here. Now in order to do the predictions, what I will do is I will just, with the help of this object name, I will just call up this method, that is predict. And inside this predict, what I need to predict, I need to pass this X test over here. Here we go. So you can just see over here. So it has given you this array, okay. And if I just show you my X test over here, so that, so see, this is our X train over here. And what I will simply do is I will just write down over here. So 0 stands for this Satosa, 1 stands for this Versicolor, and 2 stands for this Virginica. All right. So as you can see, this for the first sample over here, okay, it says that it belongs to which class? So it belongs to Versicolor. Then for the second one, it says that it belongs to this Virginica. This third sample, it says that it belongs to this Satosa. So likewise, it has given you this predictions for all of these records over here. All right. Now, next, what we can do simply over here is that we can check the score of our module. So what I'm just going to do is I will just say clf.score, and inside this I will just pass my X test and I will pass this Y test. And you can see we are getting the score, that is 97%. So 97% is quite a pretty score over here, a good score. Okay, our module is giving a pretty high accuracy. Moreover to this, you can even predict for a single item over here. So say, in order to just predict, so if I just say clf.predict, and inside this two dimension over here, if I just pass up all of these values over here, that is sepal length, sepal width, petal length, petal width over here. So let's check it out. So I'm just going to give random values over here. So let's call this as, suppose this is 3, then 5, 4 and 2. All right. Now let's check. So it says that it belongs to the class 1 over here. So class 1 is nothing but the Versicolor over here. We can do one more over here. So if I just copy paste this thing, and if I just change up this value, so this time I will just make this as, suppose 3, then this 2. Okay, let's check this thing. So it says it belongs to the class 2 over here. So class 2 is Virginica over here. All right, so we can even do the prediction for the single items over here. It was all about this random forest over here. Okay, so I hope that you have got a clear idea about what is random forest algorithm. All right, so instead of writing this guinea over here, you can go for entropy as well. So I hope you have understood with this thing. So if you just like this video, so hit the like button, share it to your friends, and do subscribe to our channel, and see you in the next video.